Welcome back to Let's Play Fire Emblem Path of Radiance. Last time we spent the entire part in the base and listening to Soren nag about stuff. But for the most part, we were just in the base, prepping for the next chapter, and here we are continuing on with Chapter 9. And they're talking about the area that we can't currently see, which is the sea. Mostly water. Water and beaches. Mostly beaches. What is it, Mordecai? Do you tire? Should we rest here? No, I think we're alright. Good. Barak are such a weak species. Distance like this is nothing. Any Lurky who's worth his claws could cross it in a single bound.
Lethe.
It's the truth.
If you persist in this way, you will shame the king. You sound like a fool.
You are my subordinate. Never speak to me in such a way.
What's wrong is wrong. You are a fierce warrior, Lethe. But when it comes to the Barak, you are far too stubborn.
What did you say? Come on now, both of you, let's calm down. Mordecai.
Wait.
What is it?
That smell on the wind. It's iron. It is a smell of weapons. They smell of Barak. Heavily armored. Well armed.
Are you sure? I wouldn't doubt the Lagoos, Ike. Just saying.
General Katov! The Crimean mercenaries have entered our area of operations.
Ha! They're trapped. Call every last man. Ready for battle. We'll stop the enemy here.
Fort Tatana.
That is a weird name for a place. Black armor. They're Daeins men, all right. You're saying that some of the invasion force is still around? Daeins worms. They strut about Gallia forests as if they owned them. I won't stand for it.
Castle to the south. Many Barak are inside. They carry iron weapons. I smell them.
Not good. Titania! Gather everyone together. Understood. What now? What do you mean? If you hope to crush the worms, you'll do well to capture the ruins in the south. Since you probably want to flee, there is an escape route. We're going to fight. Oh? There are times when running has its advantages, but I don't think we'll lose here. I see.
I will also fight.
Good. We can use the help. Ike, everyone's here.
Alright, let's go!
I want you two to take Mist and Rolf and retreat to the rear. Of course. We're counting on you. Be careful. Everyone who can fight, grab a weapon. Grell mercenaries, move out!
Before I do anything, I am repositioning the crud out of characters, which means I should probably move characters to the back more. The big problem with this chapter is the pirates. You want to get to these houses over here. Not only do they have Lagoos inside, they also give items to you, and you don't want those being destroyed. The Daeins troops won't destroy the houses. The pirates, however, will. So you want characters that can move quick. Basically, if I could check their movements, which I would love to do, but I can't at the moment. It is entirely helpful with that in regards to pretty much everything that goes on. However, we might as well just start the chapter now. We're 5 minutes in. Mist,
You and Rolf clear out of here. Stay back, no matter what.
No, Ike. We're going to fight with you, both of us.
What? No, that's not going to happen.
Be serious, miss. The two of you can't even wield weapons.
I've got this.
A heal staff?
Yeah. I made Reese teach me how to use it.
I can heal injuries. I mean, just little ones, but still.
Little ones? No. There's no way I'm letting you on this battlefield.
Uh-huh. Rolf, stop being such a brat, you little twerp.
I'm going to fight, too. I can go with a bow.
Really? That's news to me.
The best lie I can come up with?
It's no lie.
That's right, he's not lying.
Of course he is.
What are you talking about, miss?
Rolf's always practicing with his bow, and he's really good, aren't you?
I sure am.
And when did you learn to use a bow?
I guess I just sort of picked it up naturally.
Stop lying, you booger-eating twerp. You can't just pick up a weapon and start firing away. Someone has to teach you the basics.
Well, maybe I'm just a proud of you because I learned it all myself.
You little.
You don't know anything, Boyd.
That's right. This is ridiculous.
Enough. You two go back.
No, we don't want to.
All Rolf and I do is sit and wait and worry about all of you.
We're tired of waiting. We want to fight by your side.
Is that so?
How about it, Rolf? Is that how you feel too?
Uh-huh. No doubt. We'd rather be with you.
What now, Commander?
We take them with us. We're too pressed for time to be sitting around bickering.
And at least if they're nearby, they'll be easier to protect.
Are you serious?
Yes, you won't forget this, Ike, I promise.
I hope not.
Another fade-in, another death happen. And it's unfortunate because it was my favorite mage of the game. And this is still technically part of part 19. I don't comprehend things anymore.
If anything, I'm going to make sure that Ilyana is the one over here, Reese is down there, Soren over there.
Actually, you know what? Let's put Boyd over there, so that way we have these three over here, and everybody else down there. Let's just begin the battle. And at this point in time, Miss and Rolf are going to join us. It's really just them complaining about not being able to come. About Rolf being able to hold a bow, even though he says he just picked it up naturally, Boyd calls him out on it. I don't really want to sit here for another 10-15 minutes with them talking again. I really, really don't, so we're not going to. Have Rolf go up that way. We'll have Reese go with them. They could use some heal. We'll put Ike down this way. In this battle, since we have partners with us, we can tell them to either roam, halt, target, or avoid. Since technically at this point in time, I would like them to move to a specific area, being over here, I'm going to have them go out that way. Actually, I should try that again. Okay, good. Wait, let's see. Over here we have a couple of houses. Now, with these houses, there are two Lagoos in there. This pirate, and two more that pop up later, or is it three more, will go after those houses. Don't let them destroy the houses. You can get good things from there, and you don't want them being destroyed. At this point in time, we only still have a set number of units. What this means for us is that we don't exactly get to enjoy the complement of selecting different units per battle. Two of which I will let you know now. Once you start being able to pick units for combat, pick a certain set of people and stick with them. If he attacks twice, okay, good. I probably shouldn't have done that.
Regardless, I did. I screwed up. Ilyana's not dead, though. That's the main important part of that. That's literally the one thing that I am worried about the entire time. And that conversation that happened between Lethe and Ike is just her telling him that he can direct where they go with the whole directing command. I didn't want that, so I explained and took literally less time than it would throughout the entire text dialogue. Roaming would let them go wherever they want, whenever they want. Avoid means they avoid any enemy troops. Target means they go to a specific area, and halt means they stop moving. There really isn't much to discuss when it comes to them, if only because they're rather minute. In this battle phase, they really don't do much unless they're roaming or being attacked by another troop that's right next to them. Otherwise, they only really attack if they're roaming. So if you want to get them anywhere to start roaming and attacking, you want to have them at a specific point. And I would like Ilyana to go down here. Rolf. For the heck of it, go over there. Humor me. Rolf and Mist, I'm going to admit, I don't really use. So for this battle, they're more of a liability than anything else. I would prefer to not have them here, but they force themselves onto us, and I have to accept them for this battle alone. After that, I shouldn't have to use them ever again, because I didn't want them. They force themselves onto this whole mission, but for the heck of it, humor them, they'll be out in combat for one time and then never again. Just know, I don't like them. I think they're, for me, bad units. If you make them work, congrats, you made them work, but I will not waste that time that it would take to train them to that point, because at this point in time, comparing Mist to Reese has more levels compared to Mist. Why would I go to Mist if I can just have Reese? Now, I guess technically you could say the same about Rolf. We don't have an archer, and Rolf is that replacement archer. However, in a couple of chapters, we will be getting a bow knight, so what would be the point in having Rolf? Since the bow knight we'll be getting is much better than Rolf on, like, every scale imaginable. Because Rolf himself is not really that good as a fighter. And that's me trying to be as cynical as possible. 9 times 2. I will take that. Because I'm trying to get Sora in a kill here. Just don't crit. Thank you, Ike. That was all I wanted, because now Soren can kill him. Wind. Goodbye, sir. This recording took place the day after I just recorded, from 14 to the first part of this recording. My sister and her boyfriend are away on vacation, so I'm trying to take as much advantage of this opportunity to record as I can at night. Since I started later than I would have liked to, being from 10 to 10:40, but I will go longer tonight to go till about 1:30 at night. To be honest, that's one of the main things about it. Also, with the Lagoos, when they are in beast form, they are pretty much near unstoppable. But since we have them in our party, let's talk about their weaknesses. Beast Lagoos. The Lagoos that Lethe and Mordecai are, they are Beast Lagoos. They are weak to fire magic. There are also winged Lagoos, who are like ravens, crows, hawks, etc. Birds, essentially. They are weak to wind magic, which is Sorin's specialty. Lottie frickin' duh. And then there are dragon Lagoos. And what are dragons weak to? As demonstrated by Ilyana in her thing. Dragons are weak to lightning. I don't know where that came from, but they're weak to lightning now. And there is literally nothing else we could possibly say to that. Except, okay. I am okay with a lot of things this game does, to be perfectly honest. However, Mia, you couldn't get a crit this one time you did need it. Right, with big enemies that have a large health bar, it's good to have more than one unit go up against them. Like, say, with this pirate, to have Mia and Ilyana go up to it, take care of it. You didn't need that, Ilyana! She would have killed it either way, but a crit? 14 times 3 is what now? 38? No, 42, right? 14 plus 14 is 28, plus 14, yeah, 42. You didn't need that. I'm bad with math, okay? Leave me alone. Yeah, I am not putting you up against that, ever. Boyd, go protect your brother. Go be a big brother. At least hit him once. You have 2 times to hit him. Boyd, you disappoint me. I am very disappointed in you. How could you? How could you miss for your brother's sake? How could you? Because now he has to fight it. Now I feel bad. Because if Rolf dies, I'm screwed. Well, no, I can just have Rhys go up to heal him. Which I can do, because I have Rhys right next to him. Hi, Rhys. Go heal Rolf. Go heal him. Because now he will live till next turn. I believe at the end of this turn we have somebody appear up the, we have someone who will appear in the upper right hand corner of the map. For all intents and purposes, you want Ike close to there, like, pronto. Because new party members are always a good thing that aren't missed and both. You can like them all you want. If you want to use them, go ahead. I'm sure they're fantastic units, I just don't use them. I can see it about a lot of characters, to be honest. And a lot of them I would never use. Ever. Just personal preference. Just that a lot of the units that we get in this game, I would prefer not to use. There was a Titania's counter. She did half the damage he did to her. Which wasn't at all that much. What is your range? Block that out. Perfect. Missed. Go get experience, because why the heck not use you for the little time I plan to. Yeah, 11 experience per heal. I'm not going to keep using and risking that opportunity when I can use Rhys, who would arguably get more experience. And once they move to their targeted area, I don't think they really do much else. So I'm probably going to start, I'm going to have Ike direct him to just roam. It doesn't affect Rhys. Your magic is pathetic. Priests have high resistance since they are basically the healing class. They have a very high resistance, but a very poor physical defense. Which is why he reflected off that magic. And I loved it so much. If you kill Oscar, I will be pissed. You didn't need that, Oscar! But I'm glad you're alive, not all the same. Because if I lost you, we'd be screwed. Right, here is our companion from back in chapter 2, I believe? Marcia. She's finally come back. And since she likes Ike, well, we'll just have Ike go talk to her. I mean, why not? I mean, if you were Marcia, wouldn't you want a piece of Ike's ass? I'm pretty sure a lot of girls would. Except I'm not a girl, so I wouldn't really know. Soren, there you are, buddy. You can kill that guy for me. Weighing pros and cons of certain things. This whole chapter. You didn't need that, Soren! He activated Adept, which would have given him another 2 times to attack, or at least another one. and he wastes it on a crit, and he got 69 experience points. Soren, I realize how much I love you at times, and sometimes you really make me cringe. However, at this point in time, I don't really want to stretch too far into the video, since I am recording a new session proper. I'm going to call it off here, and I'll see you all next time on Let's Play Fire Emblem Path of Radiance.